want to say the selection of V belts. So for selection of V belt, we need certain information, and this information will be provided in the problem which will be given to you. First one is the type of driving unit, then type of driven unit. So depending upon the type of driver, driving unit, driven unit, and operational hours. Okay. So these first three points, they will give you that what type of load is coming. Right? So this is the something new for the V belt drive. Rest all things are similar to the flat belt drive. That is the power to be transmitted. It is required for both flat and V. Then input and output speed. Then the center distance and the type of load. Okay, so now we see that how to select a V belt drive. Step number one. First is that you have to select the load correction factor FA from the given problem. So in the problem they will mention that what is the driver unit, what is the driven unit, and what is the operational hours per day. So here in this problem they have mentioned that your compressor will be the output unit, okay, and it is going to be working for 24 hours per day. Okay, so for 24 hours per day working operational hours, you have to select the belt drive from certain standard table. So this is a table for operational hours. So for us, the power to be transmitted is 5 kilowatt, that too for compressor, and for 24 hours per day, it is given in the problem. So for power more for up to 5 kilowatt, okay, means it falls in this row for pumps or compressor, and for 24 hours working day, the value of FA, it is mentioned here. That is the load correction factor. FA is 1.3. So we are going to select the value of FA as 1.3. So this is the step number one. First you have to select the load correction factor FA. After selecting FA, you have to find out the kilowatt design. Means the power which is required to design the belt drive. So kilowatt design will be given as FA into kilowatt actual. So this kilowatt actual will be the power mentioned in your problem. Okay, so for us 5 kilowatt is mentioned. Okay, so 5 into 1.3 will be the load correction factor. Okay, and you can find out the kilowatt maximum, kilowatt design. So in the previous, in the flat belt drive, it is mentioned as kilowatt maximum. Now in this case V belt, it is mentioned as kilowatt design. So this kilowatt design is required to select the type of cross section of the V belt. We know the V belt is having trapezoidal section, right? So trapezoidal section means it is having certain width and certain thickness. Okay, so that we have to select. Again, you have to select from the standard charts and tables provided to you. Now this is the chart from which you can select the type of cross section. Okay, so for us the kilowatt design is suppose 6 kilowatt. Okay, so here 5, this is a logarithmic table. So 6 kilowatt and input speed is 1440 rpm. okay, so this is 1000, this is 2000, this is input speed in rpm. So in between the 2000 and 1000, let me say it is 1440 rpm. okay, so the type of cross section, your design point falls in the zone of type B. So you are selecting the type B type of cross section for the V belt drive. Okay, so type of cross section is the B type. So for B type cross section in the table, in the standard table, for B type of cross section, the width is 17 mm, thickness is 11 mm, and the minimum diameter is 200 mm. Now sometimes in the problem they mention this minimum diameter. So you have to take whatever mentioned in the problem. Otherwise you can select it as 200 mm. Understood? So this is a step number two. You have to select the type of cross section, and it is depends on the kilowatt design. Okay, and kilowatt design can be found out from the load correction factor. Understood? So step number 2 is over. In the step number 3, okay, you have to find out or you have to select the standard diameters of the trees depending upon the velocity ratio given to you. Okay, now for us the velocity ratio is near about 1.4. okay, so for 1.4 velocity ratio and minimum diameter of pulley, smaller pulley is 150 mm. okay, so you can select the preferred pitch diameters of the pulleys. Okay, preferred pitch diameters of the pulleys here. So this diameter, smaller diameter is 150, it is available here, 150 it is available. So multiplying this 150 by 1.485, the capital D means diameter of bigger pulley will be 222. So selecting the higher values, that is 224. So the third step is the selecting the diameters here. Okay, in the case of V belt drive, so we have selected the type of cross section and we have selected the diameters till now in the step number 3. Understood? Now fourth step in the V belt drive, you have to find out the length of the belt. Now there will be three length available for the belt. The inner length, which will be in contact with the pulley, is called as the inner length of the belt, denoted by L suffix I. Okay, pitch length is the imaginary length of the belt, and the outer length of the belt, which is denoted by LO. But for our case, we are finding the pitch length LP with the help of this formula. If it is open belt drive, again the same thing, you have to select this formula and you have to find out the LP. If it is cross belt drive, then instead of this D minus D, you have to use D plus D, because for cross belt drive the length required will be more. So it will be, instead of D minus D, it will be D plus D for cross belt. So from this formula you find out the pitch length. Now for given pitch length or inside length, inner length, LI, okay, one table will be available. From that table you can find out the correction factor for the length, okay, which is denoted by FC. Okay, we will see how to find out FC. Now suppose you found out LP, right, pitch length. So in this table number 2, there is a conversion of inside length to the pitch length of the belt. So this is for cross section B, because we have selected type B cross section. The difference between this LP and LI is 43, right? So we found out already LP from this formula. Okay, we already found out LP. Okay, so you can find out LI, okay, with the help of this difference. Understood? So what will the formula? It will be LP minus LI equals to 43, right? So LI will be equals to LP minus 43 for type B cross section. Understood? This 43 is for the type B cross section. So after getting LI, now you can use this table for LI and you can find out the correction factor for the inside length LI. Okay, now suppose for our calculation the LI is less than 1900 mm. okay, so less than 1900 mm, these values are not shown in the table, right? So we can, for type B cross section, you can select this correction factor as 0.97. okay, so if it is not available in the scope of our table, so select minimum as 0.97. if it is available in the table, suppose for us the LI is 2032, okay, or 2057, then the correction factor for that will be 0.98. understood? So select the correction factor there. Now this correction factor is required for the next step. Okay, so this correction factor is denoted by FC. So we have selected FC. Okay. So for our case, the length of belt is less than 1900 mm. So we will select the correction factor as 0.97. Okay. Now again, one more different tables are available. For this table, okay, we will select it as a point. It is available as 0.92. Okay. So this table, let me show that from where we got this 0.92. See here. This is one more table where you can select the correction factor FC. This is available in the book Bhandari. So for type B, okay, and for 1560 value of LP, okay, 1560 value of LP, the correction factor FC is 0.92. That is what we have selected in our case. Okay. Otherwise, if this table is given, you find out LI. Okay, and for the LI, you select the value. Okay. So these are the two various tables available for LP and LI, from which you can find out the correction factor for the length. The next step, after finding FC, okay, find out the arc of contact for the smaller pulley. Again, with the help of the same formula, arc of contact for smaller pulley alpha S will be given as 180 minus sine inverse of D minus D by 2C. With the help of this formula, find out alpha S. From this alpha S, you can find out its correction factor from this graph. Okay. So alpha S is, for our case, it is 171. So 150, 160 and 170. So for this 170, this graph intersects here. Okay. So the correction factor for this arc of contact will be near about 0.98. So select correction factor for arc of contact FD as 0.98. Okay, from this graph. Now after selecting FD, next step is that you have to find out the power ratings. Okay, now this power rating, it depends upon the speed of the pulleys and the diameters, and is the speed ratio. Okay, so different tables are available. Now let me show this simple table which will be available here. For B type of cross section and for 150 mm diameter of the pulley, the power rating is 3.3 kilowatt. Understood? One more table is available, which is given in the Bhandari, that for this much speed of the faster pulley, that is 1440 rpm, and for 150 mm diameter, the power rating is 3.83, and you have to find out the additional correction factor for this. Okay, so that can be determined for the speed ratio. Okay, so for us, the speed ratio is 1.4. so for 1.4, it is falling in this zone. It is now about 0.36. so you have to add this 0.36 into 3.83. Understood? If this table is given. If this table is not given, then calculation will be very easy. Okay, just select the power rating for type B cross section and for 150 mm pulley diameter as 3.3. okay, so most of the time this table will be given. Okay, so selecting the power rating as for cross section B and minimum diameter 150 mm as 3.3. Now after selecting the power rating, okay, now we have to find out the number of belts. Okay, so number of belts are given as kilowatt design, which you already calculated in the step number 1, divided by rating which you have selected just now, into the correction factor for the length which you already selected, and the correction factor for the arc of contact which already selected. Okay, so from this you will find out the number of belts. Okay, so for the given cross section, for the given power transmission, you have to find out that how many turns of the V belt required. Okay, so that is the end of the selection of the V belt drive. Understood? So thanks for your patience listening.